Fleksinja is a great player. When you watch him, you'll see some aggressive Omen plays, and to be honest, I think he's a big influence on how people like to play Omen. A lot of players associate him with aggressive Omen plays since he popularized it on his YouTube channel. However, this has led a lot of people to think that playing Omen aggressively is the only way to play him, which isn't really the case. Hi guys, this is Egwik, and today I'm going to talk about understanding your role as an Omen player and why you can't play like Fleksinja all the time. If you like this video, please consider subscribing for more quality Valorant content in the future. Now let's get into it. Omen is a very versatile agent that can fit a lot of roles in the team. He can be used as the primary smoker, a semi-aggressive duelist, or even take on a more supportive initiator role. However you want to play him is up to you, but there are certain situations where playing passively or playing aggressively will be the most beneficial to your team, and the Fleksinja-like play might not be the most optimal choice. In this video, we're going over certain examples on how you can make the correct decisions. Example number 1. If you look at my team composition, you'll realize that I'm the only source of smokes on my team. Since I'm the only smoker, my main priority is to get my smokes out and block vision so that it's easier for my team to take control of sites. With that said, if I play aggressively at the start of the round, peek an AWPer, and die, then my team doesn't have smokes for the rest of the round, making it extremely hard to perform an attacking execute. Since smokes are crucial to isolating angles, it's going to be a struggle for them to work around my death because I'm the primary and only smoker. So the correct choice in this situation was to play a bit more passively and take less risky peeks. What a lot of people don't understand is that you need to be versatile with your own playstyle to fit the needs of your team if you want the best chances of winning. So take a look at your team composition and how your teammates are performing and play to their strengths. On some days where I can't aim to save my life, I relegate myself to being a blinded smoke machine and try to create as much space as I possibly can for the rest of my team to take advantage of. This is something that only Omen can do, as he's not tied down to a specific playstyle unlike other agents. This is also why Fleksinja's Omen is very different from Mo Pork's or Sean Garrus's. Just remember that even if your aim isn't on point, there are other ways to help the team without making aggressive Fleksinja-like plays. Here's another example. If you don't have any duelists on your team, or if your duelist isn't doing very well, then it might be a good idea to try to entry frag for your team using blind and teleport setups that'll help you occupy space and clear angles. Conversely, if your team is full of duelists, then it might be a better idea to play a little more passively, support them with smokes and blinds, and let them get to work. You don't need to be playing very aggressively because you already have agents whose entire kit is built around that type of playstyle. Another thing is that you shouldn't limit your playstyle in games. Omens are best when they're unpredictable. So if you've been playing passive for the past few rounds, making an aggressive play is bound to catch your enemies off guard. On a side note, if you watch Fleksinja's stream, you'll realize that not every round is an aggressive play, and he does change up his playstyle to fit the needs of his team. Which is why when he does make those big brain plays, they work out pretty well because he's already conditioned his opponents to think in a certain way. As for myself, the group I play with has a bunch of insane entry fraggers, so I play a more supportive role on the team. I'm usually the second or third one in, so I'm the player that's trading them out if they die. The most important thing is that you're actively communicating what you're going to do, which is why if you watch my other videos, you can frequently hear me call out when I'm smoking or blinding certain areas. In solo queue, it helps to be able to judge how your teammates are performing. A quick look at the scoreboard can help with this, so that you know whether to take a more supportive role or a more aggressive one. You also need to take into account how your team behaves. Are they too scared to entry? Do they have problems clearing a certain spot? or is everyone being over-aggressive? Mix up your gameplay based on behavioral patterns to maximize team performance. Although the big brain plays are amazing for highlight reels, you need to weigh out the risk and reward of each play and which will help out your team the most. To conclude, although Flex Ninja's aggressive Omen outplays are amazing to watch, they're not always going to be the optimal decision. Before making a play, weigh out the pros and cons and think about your role and the value you bring to your team, especially if you're the primary smoker. I'm going to be making a detailed video on how to make good decisions, so look out for that. With that said, I'm not discouraging anyone from making Flex Ninja-like plays, because when they work, then you probably have already won the round for your team. Just be mindful of what you're trying to achieve and the risks that come with making the play. This is Egwik, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.